हाय, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
आई होप एवरीवन इज डूइंग वेल। सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दी वेबिनार ऑन द चेंजिंग ट्रेंड इन ग्लोबल ग्लोबल हायरिंग एंड द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ ग्रुप डिस्कशन। सो आई रिक्वेस्ट एवरीवन टू प्लीज स्विच ऑन देयर वेबकैम। Thank you. I request all the participants to switch on their webcam. Thank you. We have our guest speaker with us, Mr. Sanjay Parashar. Is he there? Are you there, sir?
Hi, good morning everyone.
Thank you very much, sir. Good to see you. All right, so are we good to start?
Yeah, please request everyone to please switch on their videos. Still few are left.
No problem, they can join in between. All right. Sanjay sir, is my screen visible to everyone?
It's visible, Mohan sir.
Yeah, visible, sir.
Thank you. All right, so let's start. I request all the participants to put their phone on mute. And there are certain guidelines before we start this webinar. The agenda of this webinar is to understand the changing trend in global hiring, especially at the time of this COVID-19 situation, that how the market is going to change in the coming days, and also the kind of impact it is going to create on global hiring. And at that point of time, how group discussion is going to play an important role at that situation, we are going to discuss that, right? So there are certain guidelines which I would like to share with each one of you. So during this webinar, all the participants are requested to be on mute, right? And there will be a time given to all the participants to discuss and interact with the speakers. In case of any audio or video connectivity issue, I request participants to use the chat box to inform the host. And if you have any question regarding the webinar, you can please note down that question. And during the question answer slot, we'll be able to discuss and address the questions. And also, in case if you get logged out because of any reason from the session, you can click on the same link and you'll be back on in the webinar room, right? And after the session, you know, we'll be connect with the participants through mail or WhatsApp in case they will require any kind of support in future. And also we will be sharing this presentation to them also, so that they can go through the presentation in future. And immediately after the call, you'll be getting a feedback form from DataRates Technologies. I request all the participants to fill that form. It will help us to you know, improve our quality. And also, you know, there are many more webinars are coming from DataRates Technologies in future. So for that, I request everyone to please share and like our pages on social media, so all the information will be available there. So I hope I made my you know, this guidelines clear to all the participants. So let's start the webinar. So under this webinar, we are going to discuss about the impact of COVID-19 on global hiring. We are also going to discuss the changing trend of 2020 in global hiring. Then there are three recruiting trends which has been anticipated by more than 200 companies. So we are going to touch upon that area also. And then we'll be talking about the importance of group discussion in the changing trend, that how group discussion is going to play an important role in this changing trend. And then we will be discussing about that, why group discussion is required by the industry at this time of change. Then we'll be talking about roles, prerequisites, few ground rules, and also the skills assessed by recruiter during the during the group discussion. Then there are certain useful phrases which we'll be sharing with you. And as I've told you that there will be a virtual group discussion, so we will be doing a small practice. And on the basis of that practice, we'll our speaker will share the feedback on the same. Right. So this is the agenda for today's webinar. Right. So very quickly, we'll talk about the impact of COVID-19 on global hiring. So as per the survey or as per the lot of information on various authentic references, we have find out that these are going to be some kind, some impact on hiring, especially at global level due to COVID-19. So the full-time job will reduce. This is going to be the very first impact which is going to be happen. And the second is remote and digital working will become the new norm. So we can see that now people are more moving towards the towards the online sessions and working remotely working at home. Work from home is now the new culture and the new norm. And of course, the salaries will become unfixed. So at this point of time, we are getting the fixed salary. But in coming days, the salary will be depending upon the kind of effort, the kind of manpower, the kind of hours we are going to devote for the hour. And the value perception will increase. Now, this is the most important thing. When I say about value perception, that means the more skills you have, it will give you a lot of the more, amount of remuneration in future. So the most important thing is to upgrade our skill during this time of quarantine period, and we can probably work upon the skill so that we will become a value proposition for all the industry in future. Also, the new job of different kind will be created, right? So what kind of job will be created? It is said that Asian economies outside China will see an increase in manufacturing job. So we can see now that many people right now moving from service industry to manufacturing industry. The reason behind is that the whole situation is moving in a different direction altogether. And this crisis has opened up path towards the manufacturing industry. Either it is healthcare, either it is retail, either it is any other field. So it is all about manufacturing jobs in coming days. And fitment will overrule qualification. Now this is important. When I say fitment, I mean to say about the attitude. The attitude or the sincerity or the dedication of an employee is going to overrule the qualification. So if you are fit as per the attitude, then you may be qualified to get a job rather than having higher education or the education from the prestigious institution. Then the reskilling and e-learning adoption shall emerge even faster. So there are times when even a lot of people who are not very much technological savvy, now they are also reskilling because of this change in the society and the change at the worldwide level. So not even in terms of this kind of skill, but even in the terms of skill, especially in IT, marketing, retail, you have to be good. So earlier we were very good in take an example that skill in one-to-one interaction for marketing people is now going to change, and we have to now reskill this negotiation skill more on online platform. So this is going to be one of the example, and for the IT industry, the more specific job will come. And company will specifically look for a candidate to have a master in one in the advanced skills in future. And if I talk about the fresh graduates, will be expected to learn by themselves and come prepared. So at this point of time, company are actually giving a lot of time to train the candidate and the resources. At this point of time, company is actually because of this global economy slowdown, now companies are expecting that all the freshers and graduate will learn by themselves. So what are the trends? What are the skills they should be able to learn so that company will take them in their organization and straight away, put them on work. So this is going to be a most important requirement from the industry now. So, when we go through such kind of, situations, it actually creates a lot of fear in our mind. So when I say fear, yes, whole industry, all the people who are right now working in any organization or looking for a job or who are on the verge of starting their career are having a lot of, you know, fear in their mind. So I would like to, you know, share one of the message which I have received today. And this message has a lot of meaning to it. And what this message says, I would like to, you know, read from my phone in front of you. So it says, you know, this is one of the CEO from one of the consulting company. It says, you know, experts are predicting huge downfall of economy due to the corona. I don't know much about these experts, but I know for sure that they do not know anything about the value of human motivation and determined efforts, right? If experts were to be believed, after the total destruction in Second World War, Japan had no future, but at the same time, in just 3 decades or so, made US cry at the marketplace. If the experts were to be believed, Israel should have been wiped out from the earth map by the Arabs, but the fact is different. As per the rules of aerodynamics, the bumblebee cannot fly, but it flies because it does not know the rule of aerodynamics. If the experts were to be believed, we should have been nowhere in 83 Cricket World Cup, but we know the, you know, the outcome. And if the experts were to be believed, Wilma Rudolph, the first American lady to win 4 Olympic gold in athletics, should not have been in a position to walk without braces. No question of running. If the experts were to be believed, Arunima Sinha can hardly lead a normal life, but she climbed the Mount Forest. So the corona crisis is no different. I do not have any doubt that we will defeat this corona hands down, and the Indian economy will bounce back in a great manner. So, you know, the situation is same. People are predicting a lot of things, but at the end of the day, we have to really understand this is all prediction, right? The more important thing we have to focus is rather getting afraid of the situation, we have to actually, you know, utilize this time in more constructive manner. Right. So moving further, it talks about the changing trend of 2020. So in global hiring. So we say that as we enter a new decade, nearly 200 CEOs from the biggest world brands have declared that their shareholders are no longer their chief concern. So it is all about employees, you know. So we can see that, you know, at this point of time, the company is more focusing on, you know, the biggest asset for the organization, and which are the employees, because they have understood at this point of time is if they are going to, you know, make shareholders happy, they are not going to sustain in the market. They need the asset for the organization. They need that kind of employee who will be dedicatedly working for the organization, even at this grave time. So this is one of the great news, I would say, right? And if we talk about the 3 recruiting trends anticipated for 2020, then I would say that there are 3 trends. You know, we have to really understand this trend is going to give us a sign of relief that yes, employees are the focus. This is the first trend, which we have also seen in the past news. What I personally believe at this point of time is, you know, that employees are the focus, but on the other hand, this is the employee's responsibility. This is the candidate's responsibility to upskill themselves. You know, we should not, you know, spend our time in lament about the situation, but also we have to, you know, actually, you know, spend more time to upgrade our skill through online platform. There are a lot of online trainings are available. So it is a humble request to all the candidates to please focus on their upskilling. If you have skills, then you don't need to worry in any situation, in any crisis, and you will definitely overcome all the situation as a great winner. Right. And the second is, you know, the priorities on diversity and inclusion. So this is going to be an important role. From last 3 years, we have seen a change in the hiring trend by many big companies like TCS, Infosys, and, you know, Wipro. These are the companies who were restricted earlier to few of the, you know, colleges only, but now they have opened, you know, their hiring platform to pan India level, where not only, you know, the specific colleges will be able to become a part of that company, but, you know, anybody can, who qualifies the eligibility criteria, can become a part of such organization. So, you know, companies are giving priorities to diversity. They are even aware that not only in metro city, but in, you know, the tier 1, tier 2 and tier 3, you know, cities are also having a lot of potential and a lot of skills. So now companies are looking for that, and they have a wonderful approach that they're including the whole nation, right? Even at this point of time, we have seen that how, you know, the big companies are contributing towards this fight of COVID-19. So we have a great example of Ratan Tata, who was actually given 1500 crore contribution towards this great fight of against the fight of coronavirus. So we can see that now these companies are actually changing their priority, and they, you know, in this lead, you know, Tata Group is always, you know, becoming the lead. So the third trend is, you know, about the millennial. So if I talk about millennial will lead the market. So millennial is that one that who are, you know, who have born especially in this year of 2000. So anybody who is in millennial will lead the market, because, you know, they have potential, they have skills, they have, you know, dedication towards work. So market, you know, these people and these experts are predicting that, you know, these people who are right now in their early, in their early 20s are going to lead the market. So this is a humble request, because this is, you know, it is actually a kind of an awareness which we would like to, you know, propagate it in all the youth, especially the youth of Delhi NCR and the, you know, all the people of India, that, you know, you have millennial should, you know, actually focus more on upgrading. Right. Moving further, you know, the situation is same. It is, you know, it is same for everyone. So there are people who take that situation as a problem, and there are people who take the situation as an opportunity. Now it is up to me. It is up to you that how you are going to take this situation. Are you going to take this whole situation as a problem, or you are going to find out the opportunity out of that situation? So I still remember, you know, one of the very good quotation from, you know, the founder of Alibaba, Jack Ma. He says, you know, I, you know, sincerely look for the problem. So when there is a problem, there is an opportunity. So we have to have that same kind of adaptation. We have to have the same kind of, you know, understanding that we actually need to look problem as an opportunity. So the moment we change our perspective, automatically, you know, a lot of challenges will, you know, you will be able to overcome from it. So now we talk about the importance of group discussion in this changing trend. So group discussion is again becoming the most important hiring process for many IT and business development roles in coming days. This is one of the statement given by the head HR, DXC. This is one of the IT company. So it says, you know, now there are situations where many people are, you know, looking for a job at this point of time. So group discussion is going to be again the most important, you know, hiring process for many companies. So why it is going to be that important, I request our speaker, Mr. Sanjay Parashar, to please, you know, enlighten us, please tell us that why and how this group discussion is going to become the important part once again. So over to you, Sanjay sir. I am stopping my screen, and I request you to please share your screen with us. Sanjay sir, you are on mute.
Thank you, Mr. Mohan sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Yes, sir. I mean, if you want, I can share my screen. Is it okay? Or you're facing any difficulty right now?
Is my screen is visible to everybody right now?
No, sir. Your screen is not visible.
Yeah, there is some problem, I hope.
I will share my screen. You can continue from there, sir.
Sure.
Over to you, sir. Is it visible to you, Sanjay sir?
Yeah, this is visible, but that all video, this is not coming in my laptop actually.
No problem, sir. You can continue. We can see you. No worries. You please continue.
Okay. So, welcome everyone. As I hope that Mohan sir has made you understood all about the group discussion, why group discussion is required nowadays. This is an integral part of recruiting process, as what we are observing nowadays that there are less job opportunities and more availability. As we see, we are big in numbers, but vacancies are very few, and we are not able to achieve this. So the recruiters, they feel that this is an easy process to scan the whole group in a very short span of time. Because one-to-one process, one-to-one interaction will take much more of their time. Hence, this is a time-saving process too. So, but one thing is very much make you understand this time, that this is a surprisingly a rejection process. What we are seeing, that out of 100 candidates, only few candidates get through the process, recruiting process. So here I would like to introduce myself so that you can feel that whether I am an eligible candidate to tell you about this or not. I am Sanjay Parashar. With a rich experience of 27 years, I am currently handling Senior Training Manager and Proctor Profile in ABS Engineering College, Ghaziabad. I have started my career as a trainer in various human resource development centers in Indian Army. For last 7 years, I have empowered many youths through various training modules and delivery sessions. I have a blend exposure of real estate and banking sector, which has given me an extra edge to serve many reputed and renowned organizations and institutions. My core competency includes establishing and making functional of many administration and training departments. I have expertise in gap identification and analysis, which help organizations to get awareness about the potential of each employee. Through my remedial skill enhancement programs, I have turned many challenges into opportunities and reported better work performances along with productivity. So today, I am fortunate enough to discuss with you the latest trends of hiring. Hope this initiative will help you in your career building. To make this session interactive, would you like to participate in giving answers of my few questions, which will make me know your understanding about the group discussion? Should I ask questions? Sorry, you people are not visible on my screen.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Whomsoever is feel comfortable, please give answers of these few questions. Mm-hmm. The question one, which of these are vital for any organization? Is it debates, group discussions, speeches, or arguments?
So many. Yeah.
Yes, yes, Prabhat.
Group discussion.
Group discussion, right, Prabhat? Thank you. The next question is, which of these qualities are important in a group discussion? Is it emotional stability? Is it hostility, ignorance, or aggressiveness?
Emotional stability.
Right, Ishan. Thank you very much. My third question is, in a group discussion, one must communicate with hostility, ignorance, knowledge, or long sentences?
Knowledge.
Knowledge. Again, thank you, Jean. Thank you very much. When is the worst time to break into a discussion? When everyone is silent? when one person is talking, when two or three people talking simultaneously, when there is less time left. Yes.
When everyone is silent.
When everyone is silent, there is a quite good time to speak. But the question is, what is the difficult time? When is the difficult time?
When everyone is discussing.
When everyone is discussing. Great, great. So, I hope that you are having a fair understanding about GD. So now, the success mantra. Hope I am audible to everyone.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. The success mantra in any group discussion is simple. That is read, learn, and share with others. This is how you start developing and enhancing your opinions. People say that reading is very important, but they forget that reading gives repository of ideas, and you frame your viewpoints only when you share with others. So what are those tips that make you noticeable in a group discussion? You may get a lot of do's and don'ts for a group discussion, but the most fundamental and crucial techniques for getting noticed are initiating, leading, and concluding. Right? What are the three most important? Yes? It is initiating.
Leading.
Yes. And what is the third one?
Concluding.
It's concluding. Great. So, let us start with initiate the GD. By beginning a group discussion, you not only grab the opportunity to speak, but also everybody's attention. By starting a GD, you will get maximum uninterrupted and continuous time to put forward your view, ideas, and skill to the assessor, as other members are still busy in understanding the topic. Try to make an impression through your content, communication, and presentation skills while beginning a GD. Start only if you have properly understood the topic and have some knowledge about it. Try to give right direction to a GD by giving logical points. Start a GD by giving a quote, definition, questions, facts, figures, and statistics, shocking statements, short story or general statement. Like, as you have seen that Mohan sir has told you certain facts about the latest hiring trends. Do not consume a lot of time after beginning a GD, as it will give an impression that you started a GD for sake of just starting it. If you have not started the GD, don't lose heart. You can still enter the GD and make your presence felt. So enter the GD midway. Identify a way to enter a group discussion, as every GD has its high and lows. Try to enter a GD during low times. Try to enter the GD after a member has made his or her point, but do not take much time. Try to enter by making a supportive or acknowledging statement in favor of the last point made, as other members will think you are favoring them and they will let you speak. So it takes great talent to speak sense continuously and hold everyone's attention. Once you have made a breakthrough in the GD, try to drive the discussion towards a goal or some sort of conclusion. So lead and carry on the GD. Try to bring and incorporate new ideas in the GD. You can creatively modify ideas presented by others and develop them during the group discussion. Try to obtain support from others members of the group discussion through your body language, eye contact, and oral etiquette. Find out if the group discussion is on track or not. If the group discussion is going off track, try to bring it back on the topic. Take the initiative. This is your last chance to seize attention. Concluding the GD is as important as the beginning, as it showcases your potential to assimilate and assess before drawing an inference, which is a key requirement of successful manager. So how to conclude the GD? Summarize all points discussed in the GD in a nutshell. While concluding, avoid raising new points. Do not emphasize on your individual viewpoints only when summarizing the GD. Keep the conclusion concise and to the point. While summarizing, include all important points that developed during the group discussion. If one member has inferred the group discussion, do not contradict unless the conclusion has flaws or you have some essential point to add in it. So during the whole process, which I have briefed you, hope it made you understood that what exactly we need to do in a group discussion process. So let me define here your role you can play in GD to get noticed by the recruiter. So as I have already briefed you, that initiation is the first step. So you can work there as an initiator. So you starting a GD, giving definitions, suggesting and introducing new ideas and approaches as an initiator. You should be information seeker in the GD, gather and solicit information from others. You should be also information giver. During GD, share information and facts so that people will get to know and aware about the facts to go on any conclusion. You should work as a procedure facilitator. Lead the GD by keeping track of the discussion. You should be opinion seeker. Ask other member of the GD for their opinion so that you can discuss a broader view of the concept or the topic on the center table. You should be opinion giver too. Giving your opinions and view in the GD on the statement or arguments given by the other members. You should be clarifier, clarifying all the ideas and opinions discussed during the GD. There should be no chances of ambiguity during the discussion. You should work as a social supporter, giving support to ideas of all members of the GD. No doubt, They should work as a tension reliever too, where you can present and discussing the problem from a broad and unbiased perspective. You should be energizer, encouraging other members to explore some new ideas and notions during the GT. As a compromiser, you should create harmony between different opinions by giving a compromising solution. Don't stick on your thought process only, because we are sitting here to discuss about some problem. So you should work as a gatekeeper too, involving other members in GD by asking for their opinion. And at last, you should work as a summarizer, where summarizing or concluding the GD by including all important points discussed. So by putting this role, you can have the mastery of group discussion, right? So till now, is there any problem in understanding about the GD? Yes.
I think it's clear, sir. We can move ahead.
We can move ahead. Right. So, prerequisite of GD, it is before doing any work, we should plan it. We should prepare it well. We should have the knowledge of surroundings so that we can have ample facts and figure with us, so that we can put those facts in support of our thought process. Communication skill should be outstanding so that you can make other people understand. Your interpersonal skills should be also at number one, because we are sitting in a group and we should be able to respect each and everyone's self-esteem. Body language and personal appearances is also an integral part of our group discussion. You should be calm and cool. Like we are sitting here, we are discussing. So you should look normal. Your listening skill should be up to the mark, because without listening, we are not able to give answers of anything. Alertness and presence of mind to grab the others' one ideas. And last but not the least, you should have out-of-box thinking so that your ideas should be welcomed by everyone or person in your group. Right? So what are the four important ground rules before we start the GD? You should have pen and paper so that you can jot down your thought process and you can assimilate it, and you need to have a proper time to discuss in a group. You should have a wristwatch, because you will be getting only 10 minutes of time to discuss on a topic. So you should make yourself understand that how much time I should speak in a GD. How should I grab the opportunity to speak in a GD? When to speak, what to speak, how much to speak. Address while speaking. You should have an eye contact with everybody in the group so that people will understand you. And no doubt, the participation is integral part of the basic preliminary part of the GD, because you need to participate, you need to speak, you need to have an attitude of interacting with the people in a group. So these are the ground rules. And as I have already said you earlier in this presentation, that start with some quotations or saying, it will attract the people. They will listen to you carefully. You should have facts and figures with you. You should have examples and current affairs, which will prove your knowledge, that will prove your depth of knowledge. References, same here. Your humor, how much happy you are, whether you are enjoying a group discussion. Because at the time of recruitment, we people are suffocated enough, we are having a fear in our mind that whether I will be chosen by the recruiter or not. But once you inducted in any corporate, there you will be discussing time and often to have a solution of any problem. Avoid being talking terror. As a human being, you should be quite amiable to discuss your thought process, to share your thought process, feeling, your behavior with the person, those who are sitting there. Right? So these are the few requisites. What are the skill assessed by recruiter, if I should say in a nutshell, that what are the requirement of the recruiter? No doubt the number one is, I'll go with this slide, but prior to this, I'll tell you the number one is your initiating skill. Number two is your confidence. Number three is your depth of knowledge. Number four is your power of expression. And the last one is your interpersonal skills. Wherever you are on this globe, you will be chosen by these main qualities. Your communication skills should be good. Your interpersonal skills should be good. Leader skill, that will reflect. If you are aware with your surroundings, if you are linked with your friends, if you are linked with the latest news. Team building skills, you should know the good and the bad qualities of your friends and the person to with whom you are sitting with. You should have clarity over ambiguity so that your thought should not be intermingled or it shouldn't be become argumentative during the discussion. You should have divergent thinking so that you can view a broader perspective of the institutional vision or the organizational vision. Your list skills should be good so that you can understand the other's thought and you can respond in respect to that thought process. Your presentation skills, that should be outstanding, no doubt. It's all your bearing and turnout. It's all your body language. It's all your communication skills. The way you speak, the way you sit, the way you talk to the people, that all together comes into the presentation skills. And analytical and logical skills should be there. What you are talking, there should be some sense. There should be some logic. Your thought process should be streamlined with your thought process. Streamlined with the subject. Streamlined with the problem which you are discussing. You are there to solve the problem and put forward the solution. So, how we should speak, how we should add some valuable points in the discussion, how should we come out as a distinct person in that particular group so that recruiter will choose us. While introduction, there are few etiquettes that how to introduce yourself, how to introduce the topic, so that the other people should feel gratified. You should introduce like, with due respect, I would like to put forward the point that if you are agreeing, then you should say, I totally agree with. As a matter of fact, the person is right by saying that. It's not like that, that without agreeing, without showing your gesture, you are speaking everything, you are telling anything. No. If you are disagreeing, even then also, you show your put forward your etiquette. With due respect, I believe it would be wrong if you have a certain logical point to support your thinking, then you should add your valuable point at that point of time. You should be able to suggesting your opinion by telling, my honest opinion would be that the way I see it, it's my opinion because everyone are there, everyone is there to share his or her opinion. When you are asking for clarification, it's not like that, that you are asking why you are telling like this. This is not so. No. Gently you should say, I'm sorry, but could you please make it more clear? This is how you can ask for clarification. If you are not getting time to interrupt or jump into the GD, then interrupting should also be polite. Sorry to interrupt you. If you get any flaw, you should interrupt, because this will be an golden opportunity. This will be a golden opportunity for you to jump into the discussion at that point of time. So I would like to add here that you can add your valuable point there. So these are the certain phrases through which you can be a good group person. Your interpersonal skills will pave a path for your great career building, right? So this is how we should go about the GD. Now, till now, do you have any confusion or do you have any question in your mind? Because just after this questioning, I'll tell, give you a topic to discuss, just a model GD over here. Yes, anyone having question? There are so many doubts in you. Yes, anyone?
Sir, I think we can continue with the discussion. After that, we will be clarifying the doubt with them, right?
Right, Mohan sir.
Thank you,
sir. So please come up with the discussion. Please tell the modus operandi of discussion, how will we discuss. And after feedback session, we will have a question answer.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Sanjay sir. Now the time has come where we are requesting all of all the participants to please participate in a small discussion. This discussion would be of only 5 minutes. And the topic, as you can see, is here, that is COVID-19, an antivirus of nature. So we have been oftenly, you know, reading a lot of information, a lot of, you know, posts over the Facebook and other social networking site that, you know, that our nature is healing because of this COVID-19 you know, situation, because people are staying at home. So whether it is India or across the globe, people are doing a lot of, you know, the nature is actually giving a proof that, you know, it is healing. So is COVID-19 an antivirus? So this is going to be a discussion part. I request, you know, few of the people to participate in it. So I'm going to take the name. right, of all the participants that who are going to be a part of this discussion. And I request all the participants to, you know, the name whom I'm going to take, please, you know, put your video on so that we'll be able to see your faces also. Once we'll have this discussion, we'll have a feedback session also. And the feedback session will be, handled by Sanjay sir. So I request Ishan, I request Prabhat, I request Shruti, I request Rohan, I request Vinay Kumar Seni, I request Sarika, ma'am, and I request Osama Chaudhary, right? And I request Suman, Nitika, Yuvraj, right? So please switch on your camera, and even Nitika also can switch on your camera and mic and be a part of this discussion. All right, so can we start the discussion now? So there are 5 minutes by stopwatch, and you have 1 minute time to think about it. In just next 1 minute, we'll start the discussion. So your 1 minute time of making the note starts now. Right. So we have 30 seconds now. Shruti, Vinay Kumar Seni, I hope you all are listening. Right. Suman, Osama, Nitika. All right. So we have 1 minute over now. So we have 5 minutes time. And I request all the participants to start the discussion. Time starts now. Start.
Good morning, fellow candidates. Right. So I'm Ishan. And as the topic talks about how COVID-19 can be a helping agent to improve better our nature, I strongly go with that statement because as you can see, a few statistics like, out of the 14 cities which were a part of the most polluted cities of the world, cities in India, only two of them are there now. Air pollution has gone down drastically, which just means that human intervention was making it worse. But because of the stringent measures like, global lockdown, people are not going out that much, not much vehicular movement, not much industries are working. So that has really helped, curb the air pollution to an extent. And also because of that, the water pollution to some extent has gone down.
All right. All the members, please share your views upon this topic. You can unmute yourself and share your opinion. Prabhat, Rohan, Yuvraj, Shruti, Vinay, anybody? Suman, Nitika, or maybe Ishika also. If anybody has a point, please share it with us.
Hello.
Yeah, please, Rohan.
Am I audible?
Yes, you're audible.
Okay. So I'm Rohan. So I'm totally agree with his statement. So I just want to say that COVID virus is basically. वैसे तो मैं can I speak in Hindi?
No, you cannot. Hello. All right. Speak in Hindi. I'm joking. Please speak in Hindi. Okay. Express yourself.
Thank you. मैं सिर्फ ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि सर जो COVID-19 है वो एक एंटीवायरस की तरह तो एक मतलब काम आ रहा है. जैसे कि आप देख रहे हैं कि जो हमारी पॉपुलेशन है जो हमारा पॉल्यूशन है बहुत कम हो गया है ड्यूरिंग द लॉकडाउन की वजह से हमारा पॉल्यूशन बहुत कम हो गया है. और जैसे कि हम देख रहे हैं कि बहुत से अच्छे आउटकम्स हमें मिल रहे हैं सब चीजों में वेदर इट्स आर So this is what I just want to say that बहुत से outcomes आए हैं इन सब चीजों से this COVID-19 की वजह से और एक अच्छी मतलब I think it's good.
Thank you Rohan, thank you very much.
Effect भी हमें पड़ा.
Thank you. Okay. Is there anyone else who would like to join us in discussion? Prabhat, would you like to join? Shruti, Vinay, Yuvraj, please share some point. Nitika, Suman, Anybody? Yeah, this is, you know, the very important part which Sanjay sir has shared, that if we not participate in discussion, there is no point of any ground rule, no point of any understanding or knowledge. So the very first and important thing is to participate. I request all the participants to please share your opinion about this statement of is COVID-19 an antivirus of nature or not? Please participate. I think no one has any point. Yuvraj, why don't you participate?
Mohan sir, can you hear me?
Yeah, who's this?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, please continue.
Hello.
Yeah.
So, Mohan sir, I'm Nabil.
Yeah, Nabil, please.
I was waiting for you to call my number. I'm afraid I won't be able to switch on my video given the bandwidth will not allow.
No problem.
But I would also want to share my thoughts on the given topic. Given the fact it concerns most of us, or rather all of us, right?
Please continue.
So, definitely, this crisis has impacted in reducing the pollution levels to a very significant levels. But I would not call it a antivirus for the nature, because I'll tell you what my thought process is. Let's say if we are calling this an antivirus, we as a human being who are on the top of this chain are affected, the food chain are affected by this virus. So if we are getting affected by this virus, so this appropriately calling it an antivirus for let's say nature would not be the right adjective to address it. Though I support, I'm completely aligned to the fact that this virus, because of this crisis. Hello, guys.
You're audible.
Beg your pardon here, because the bandwidth in my case is very less. So probably there would be certain.
No, you're audible. You're audible. So please continue.
I beg your pardon for that. Yeah. So I think I put myself. I put my point that I would not call it an antivirus for the nature, but surely because of this, a lot of things have improved, and most significantly in the air pollution thing. Yeah. And the reason is because we as human beings, or there are certain other animals who are getting affected because of this, and they are also a part of nature, right?
Right. So thank you very much, Nabil. Thanks a lot for your point. I request other members also to participate. Yuvraj, Shruti, Sarika, or maybe, you know, or any other member who have already participated can also put your point there. We are already over short of time. We have last 1 minute. I request the participants to participate, and then we'll move towards the feedback session. Last 1 minute, guys. Come on. Participate. Shruti, you're listening? I can see you. Yuvraj, participate. Yes, please participate. Last 30 seconds. Right. So, unfortunately, we have to, time is up now, and we have to quickly move towards the feedback session. Sanjay sir, you don't have a lot of people to give the feedback. We have Ishan, Rohan, and Nabil. Right. So, I request you to please share the feedback with us. Sir, you are mute. You are on mute. You're on mute, sir. Please continue, sir.
Not much of the feedback, but I must appreciate the confidence of Ishan. She has come up with his idea at the very first moment. So he is a good initiator. He dared to say something about the topic. And next is Rohan. He's spoken at the second place. He was also in favor of this topic. but very few logic and concept, facts and figure were missing. And lastly, at the third stage, Nebel has given his points. So not much elaborative, no explanation was there, but need to improve a lot in this, because the essential fact and what is required in GD, which I have already shared with you, that we should have an ample knowledge of our general awareness. Until unless we don't have this, we will not able to speak in a group. So anyway, these three person, they have spoken, at least they have participated. Thank you very much.
Maybe we can have a lot of participation at the question answer slot. So guys, the floor is open for question and answer. I request anybody, any participant has any question, please ask, right? And we'll try to answer the question. Anybody has any question, please participate. Has anyone any question, please? Do we have question, guys?
So Mohan, sir, maybe.
Yes, sir. Nabil, your voice is breaking. Sorry.
It's not clear.
Sorry. Maybe you can write your question on chat box. That will be helping us. We can read from there and maybe answer that question. Right.
Is it now better? Can you hear me more?
Yeah, it is better.
I do not have a question.
Yes, I do not remember you.
We remember you. We remember you. Don't worry. We know you. And we'll get back to you after this call. We are very well aware. The moment we saw your name, we remember you only. So don't worry. After this call, we'll catch back to you.
Right? That was what you actually... The intent behind getting it on the floor for this question. Hello.
Yeah, Neville, your voice is breaking actually.
Right.
So maybe we can. Issue. I'll connect on a normal call post there.
Yeah. Okay. Post this. We will call you. We'll post. Yeah. Thank you. So any other person has a question, please. You know, this is a great opportunity.
Yes, sir, I have a doubt. Yeah, I have a doubt, sir. So
please ask.
Whether you're initiating or whether it's in between the GD, if a participant is talking or giving their views and points and no one else pitches in, so for how long should they keep going? Or what is the trick to stop talking and, you know, not look like you're out of knowledge?
Okay. Mohan sir, should I give the answer?
Please sir, please.
Yes, Ishan, very good question. If everyone is talking and nobody is stopping and they are continuously, deliberately giving their points, so you need to understand that if there is any flaw, if there is illogical thought process comes into, or if there is a variation in facts and figure, if there is some more valuable points with you, you can interrupt in between by showing your gesture and applying few phrases which I have already mentioned in this presentation. So you can speak in between, or you can jump into the group discussion with few more valuable points. Your impact of your knowledge should be as such that people will start listening to you. Once you start speaking, if someone will raise his volume, even then you need to simultaneously talk during the GD. Otherwise, if you will stop your voice, then it will be negative point for you. Right, Ishan?
Thank you. And you can also, you know, while people are discussing, you can always, pick one person who is actually talking sense, or I would say, you know, talking in your favor, and in a manner of appreciating that person. You know, you can say that suppose somebody is talking and having the same opinion which you have. So, you know, while pitching into the discussion, you can say that, I am really, you know, giving my support, or maybe I'm in totally consensus with this particular person. However, I would like to add some point at the discussion. So with that help, maybe you will be able to contribute. So appreciation is the most important key here. The moment you appreciate anyone, people will stop listening. You know, people will stop and they started listening to you. So you can always pitch in by appreciating, you know, all the members in the discussion. Right, Ishan?
Great.
Yeah. Any other question?
Appreciation is a good way.
And sir, what if people are not talking? If people are not participating, and just one person is talking continuously, then what?
Right. So in that case, maybe you can, as sir has said, you know, as a procedural facilitator, you can always initiate the discussion. You can always encourage people, right? As a gatekeeper, you can always appreciate that. Why don't you put your point across? This discussion will be healthy if everyone will participate into it, right? So you can encourage people. Right. Maybe you can give questions to them. So what is your opinion about this particular thing? Why don't you share your thought process on this? So maybe you can become a facilitator at that point of time. And with the help of that, you will be able to engage people in the discussion. Right.
Also, you should be a information giving person so that they will grab your information. In addition to that, they will respond your this thought process. Right. So continuously, you should be talking, you should be giving them information so that they can seek information and they can come up with their own ideas.
So anybody has any question? All right. So I would like to take further from here, Sanjay sir. Right. So this
please.
I would like to tell you a little bit more about the coming webinars. So we are going to hold certain technical webinars also. You know, yesterday we had a webinar on blockchain technologies. We are in future coming up on the webinar of cybersecurity. We are coming up with a webinar on software testing, robotic process automation, right, and IoT based devices. So these are the kind of upcoming webinars which are coming on us. So in order to know more about us, probably you can visit our website. You can mail us through this email ID, which is connect@datarates.com. You can also follow us on Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, and Twitter. Or if you have any query, you can generally just write your mail and you'll be able to get all the information. So I request all of you, please participate and enhance your knowledge. This is the best time. Upskill yourself, reskill yourself, and have a lot of information about the surrounding. So that is all about us. Thank you very much who have joined us today. And it's good to see a lot of people here today. Thank you very much. All the best. And
thank you very much, everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you. Goodbye, everyone.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Mohan sir. Thank you, Sanjay sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, Naveen.
Thank you.